Transforming perspectives. The BIOTraCes project coordinators on their way to a four-year adventure to boost biodiversity. This unique research journey includes 9 ecological and societal case studies throughout Europe. One of the case studies is a planned eco-community in this area in Wageningen, Netherlands. The social scientists from Wageningen Environmental Research will support the founders of the community.
Okay, as Wageningen Research, we have a case study about nature-inclusive building, which also reflects on nature-inclusive lifestyle.
Partly in tiny houses, partly as an eco-village, and partly in buildings where people can live together and take care of each other.
We're not used to building in this way, so there are many barriers to changing our way of building. That is what we want to investigate.
Overall, the BIOTraCes researchers want to explore and overcome the obstacles of biodiversity in Europe. Therefore, they will tackle public policies, local and corporate strategies to be more inclusive and just. To achieve this goal, 11 research centres and universities will closely collaborate. They will perform 9 case studies together with local partners. Among them, supporting traditional herding in Hungary, recovering a river valley in Sicily, encouraging traditional farming in Romania, and, of course, paving the way for nature-inclusive building in Wageningen. Let's talk to Paulina Saltit. She is one of the initiators of the planned eco-community.
I would like to live in a neighborhood where people take care of each other, where they can meet easily and where they take care of nature.
Paulina's group and 4 other initiatives have been collaborating for years. Their goal, to transform this area into a sustainable housing ground. But there are many problems.
The main obstacles we meet is that institutions and the stakeholders are not used to citizens' initiatives and the bureaucratic rules. They make it a bit difficult and they make it slow.
Talking about twists and turns of bureaucracy, the former hospital and the neighbouring buildings need to be demolished to make room for sustainably built houses. There will be about 60 of them. But before this can even start, the government wants a feasibility study.
The permits, is it really possible in terms of regulation to establish an eco-village and the tiny houses? But also about the pollution, how much money is involved to clear up the pollution, which is partly in the ground underneath the former hospital.
Yet against all odds, Paulina and the eco-community would like to buy the land and live in harmony with nature. Paulina has a very personal relationship with this spot.
It's the place where I always went running, but also where my children are born, in the hospital which used to be there. Yeah, so I would love to live here. Yeah, and I think it's very important anyway that this place stays a beautiful place. Yeah.
The Wageningen Environmental Research Team will support the eco-community to reach their goal. A challenging journey towards the transformation of mindsets, perfectly placed in social science.
I really like my work and I like to be a societal scientist. So it's much more about how you as a scientist can make a contribution to society.
The major contribution of BIOTraCes will be a theory of transformative change towards the end of the project. It is based on the results of the 9 case studies. The researchers will outline crucial steps towards biodiversity recovery in Europe. and they will develop public and private strategies for initiating, accelerating and upscaling transformative change. Go for it.